let me tell you through one by one what is it we intend to do on all the subsidies and what are the mitigation measures that we intend to take. Fuel. We suggest that fuel prices will be increased gradually over time, that petrol should increase by 15 cents a litre, we need to increase that, and diesel needs to increase by 10 cents a litre, and LPG by 10%, and also what's called super subsidy to increase from 0.17 to 0.40 per litre cent. Then you have, thereafter, every 6 months, 10 cents a litre for fuel and 20% for subsidy every 6 months for 5 years. Because we are so far away from the market prices. The issue here is if you want to do it all together now, I think it's tremendous hardship for everyone. Our view is that we'll have to take this in phases and phase it out over 5 years rather than bang everything in 1 year. What are the mitigation measures, the things that will make sure that people don't suffer so much hardship? Because it's so difficult to know who's poor and who's rich in this country. So we've decided to say this. If you own a car, that is a small car, a car that has less than 1,000 cc, and you have a My ID card, you turn up at the post office and you will get cash rebate of 126 ringgit per car per year. You get that, that's the cover for the internet. And if you have a small bike in less than 200 cc, you can bring along your my car to the post office. You can collect 54 ringgit. Hopefully, the very rich people don't turn up. And so, because it's very difficult to know who's poor, etc., that's why we decided to take this as a proxy to identify who's poor and who's rich. But never mind, if the rich people come and do it, we'll still pay anyway. Because it's very difficult to discriminate. This will cost the government 526 million to do this mitigation plan. But as a result of being able to do this, we will save the following. Being transparent, we put the numbers there. We save 1.3 billion this year. We save 5 billion next year and 8 billion, etc. So in the 5-year period, we will be able to save 44.9 billion in 5 years. As a result of this thing that we're doing on fuel. We are also looking at the possibility, and we're engaging with the public sector on this, about introducing what's called a floating price mechanism. That means along the time when we do this, we agree we can shift towards a floating, that means 30 cents a liter, and then later on we drop the 30 cents a liter to 25 cents, and then to 20 cents, to 15 cents, and until it becomes zero. The subsidy, that means if the oil price rises, we pay more. If it comes down, you pay less. That's called a floating price mechanism. We're not recommending that we do that immediately because it takes time for the oil companies to get ready and the pumps need to be able to communicate to the car dealer, etc., etc. And then the price changes, etc., we need to do, but we are reviewing that. On electricity, we propose to increase electricity tariff for the gas sector by 4.65 cents per MMBTU for the, if you like, the power sector. For the non-power sector, to increase it by 2.52 ringgit per MMBTU. For the electricity tariff, we then propose to increase the 0.024 per kilowatt hour. And thereafter, to increase the gas price for both the power sector and the non-power sector by 3 ringgit per MMBTU, and then electricity tariff to increase by 0.016 per kilowatt hour every 6 months for 5 years. The government, as a result of this mitigation factor, will actually spend, or will be able to save over 5 years, 35.9 billion, and these are the numbers on an annual basis. The tolls, ladies and gentlemen, I now return to the question of tolls. Tolls is a very hotly debated topic in the lab. There were people that said, my God, Idris, we shouldn't have these concessionaires. The government should have built the tolls and no need to charge tolls for those highways. When we had a look at it, if we were to take over all those highways with toll, the government will have to spend something like 300 billion ringgit to take back all the tolls. And for the government to pay to take back all the tolls, the total amount of money we will have to increase income tax and collect it from everybody in this country over 20-year period. We must allow the toll rates to rise according to the concession agreement. How do we do it? So we suggest mitigation, that we will increase the toll rates only for highways that have alternatives. We will say we will give you a discount for every 80 transactions per month. Every 80 transactions per month, I mean how many times you use it? For every additional, we give you a 20% discount for the next reload if you use the car. So, if you're a heavy user, we also give you the discount. If you don't want to pay, use the highway that doesn't have a toll. And for this mitigation factor, it will cost the government 60 million ringgit a year, and the saving to the government is the following. In 5 years, we save 3.7 billion ringgit, price of sugar, flour, and cooking oil. We propose to increase sugar price by 20 cents per kg. And we continue to increase that every year until the year 2012. For flour, we propose to increase this by 20 cents per kg for this year, and next year we increase by another 25 cents per kg. For cooking oil, for 1 kg, we increase by 15% this year, and thereafter another 15%, and thereafter 5% every year until the year 2014. As long as you have a My Card or My Kit, you can turn up at the post office, and then you'll get immediately a rebate from us, 20 ringgit cash. So if you're a family of 5, you get 100 ringgit. Whether you are big or small, whether you actually consume a lot of sugar, never mind. But we still give you the money. If you're rich also, we give you the money. The millionaire also receives. But please don't come now. So that is for the first year we will give, and the cost to the government just to do this is to the tune of 560 million ringgit this year. What we intend to do, and if we can do this, and it's complicated to do, in the second year, we want to go into a discount card mechanism, so that we will give it to the people, so we know who we give the discount card to, that means people who really need it, and then at that time, we will use some designated shops, where people can buy the provisions in the shop, and that will cost us less, that means 200 million a year. We realize this is very difficult to do because a lot of network issues, a lot of things we need to do. This 20 ringgit is not to give you free sugar, to cover for the incremental price for sugar, the increment for cooking oil, and the increment for flour, and also the increment for cooking oil or cooking gas. And as a result, all these that I put just now, I add it all together, the savings that we will take as a country, we will then be able to save this year alone 3.9 billion ringgit, and then we save 14 billion ringgit next year. The following year, we save 21 billion, and the following year, 2013, we save 29 billion, and the year 2014, we save 35 billion ringgit. When you add all of these savings together, that's 103 billion ringgit. Lest some of you may think we have a lot more money to spend, I'm telling you no, because that saving is actually to reduce our deficit. Because kita sekarang ada hutang, we have debt, because we're spending more than we actually earn. So this saving that I described is not money for us to suddenly go and spend. It is money for us to reduce our level of debt, our deficit, so that we will not become another Greece by the year 2019, where our debt equals the GDP, and so that we do not overburden the future people.